almost singularly focused on completing construction of the space station.
I think back of all the challenges and all the things that had to work right. You know, a lot of these interfaces never came together before. All the shuttle flights, the 20-plus shuttle flights that went into assembly, all the Soyuz flights, the Progress flights. To see this station come together in assembly is a true testimony to the international partnership. This is probably the most amazing research facility ever constructed in space, and it's constructed internationally, and it operates every day, 24 hours a day, doing world-class research internationally. And there is no more amazing facility than what we have in orbit.
Through and possibly beyond 2020, the ISS will serve as the world's first full-time research laboratory in microgravity. Among zero-G experiments already conducted aboard the station, several have led to promising breakthroughs in the research and treatment of cancer. Many other on-orbit science findings have the potential to significantly improve quality of life back on Earth. In May 2009, Atlantis and its STS-125 crew took to space not to visit the ISS, but to return to the Hubble Space Telescope for its final servicing mission. On five spacewalks, Atlantis astronauts repaired and upgraded the Hubble Telescope to significantly improve its capacity to explore the depths of the universe until at least 2014.
I think of all the fingerprints that are all over this thing.
It's a phenomenal piece of machinery. It's a phenomenal airplane.
And it really is an engineering marvel.
The space shuttle will go down in history as one of the great flying machines that America has produced.
The space shuttle, you know, at this time was a vehicle for bringing people together from all around the planet and having us work in harmony for the betterment of humankind.
We may not have understood when we first built it what all we'd be able to accomplish with it. And after many years, we've realized just how useful it has been.
It's been a learning experience on how to operate and live in space.
What can you say about the space shuttle? It has changed everything.
Well, the shuttle, from my perspective, is one of the great things that this nation has done.
It was a lot of pride.
Like I said, it's inspiring to come to work every single day to work on this program.
I'd go tomorrow if I had the opportunity.
Liftoff of the Challenger of Columbia. Discovery. The shuttle has been landed.
For more than 30 years, the fleet and thousands of Americans dedicated to its safety and success have toiled in exhilarating triumph, heartbreaking tragedy, and most often, quiet obscurity. Their contributions have extended beyond the bounds of space. Among others, shuttle-derived technologies have been used in developing an artificial heart and limbs, three-dimensional biotechnology, a light for treating tumors in children, and improving crime prevention and wildfire detection. From crawler driver to payload specialist, from scuba diver to pilot, from scientist to engineer, they and many like them throughout the nation share a commitment to sending humankind safely into space. That dedication, as much as any other acclaim, will be the legacy of America's space shuttle.
I think we'll be remembered in thousands of years, you know, as perhaps the most incredible technological feat of humans of our time.
As is the order of life, an ending for the space shuttle becomes a beginning for a space-bound successor. Soon, America will again send astronauts into orbit and beyond to do what NASA does best,